fight, and that's I don't condone. I got homies behind the wall wishing they was home. They got jammed up, kept discussing business on the phone. But Scotty, boy, we 200 bands off them $20. I'm going by myself when it's time to f*** up. That way police don't have a clue when turn up. I'm dolo when I'm out making different moves. Pull up to the shop just to pick and choose. I'm that, don't get confused, cause even when the prayed I did, I didn't lose. Machine.
I done seen the best of them jammed up. 25 to life in the gas tank. Never met a man that they can't talk. I'm talking on the phone, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on?
Hey everybody, it's the coach and this is Madden 19 on EA Sports.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Madden Legends and the Madden Elites. Here's the former Saint and Viking Morten Andersen to get this one started. And we are underway from the City Beautiful. Begin the drive with Hunt, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last play got just a yard. Here's 2nd and 9 from the 26. Brady gonna throw, flush to his right. And that one's complete to Gurley. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5. Brady to throw on 2nd down. Looking deep for Julio. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Deion Sanders, the Hall of Famer, with a pick. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown. Yeah.
Last one, that hurts. Following the interception, Young, and incomplete to open things up. Jalen Ramsey right there in coverage to knock it away.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up 2nd down.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on 2nd and 10.
Gone, 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 gone.
Young to throw again on 2nd and 10. Over the middle, that's caught by Rice. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
A nice catch there by Jerry Rice. And when you look at the yardage he compiled in his NFL career, it seems staggering at 22,985 yards. But let's put a little context with it.
Yeah, we ran the numbers earlier. Larry Fitzgerald, who was contemplating retirement this past offseason, would need 7 more 1,000-yard seasons to break Jerry Rice's record.
That's context.
To throw on second down is Young. That'll be caught over the middle by Moss. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Third down, Young from the gun. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. Luke Kuechly in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss. And that'll lead to a fourth down.
But that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big shot.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
The Madden Elite's offense coming back on the field. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one. Yeah, now it was the safety that came through and made the play, but there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker, and we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. On second down, it's Bell. Bell so light on his feet. And this time, he's able to take it down to the 42. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be third down. Brady. And that is incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt that in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. It's Brady. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, but now it's first and 10. Brady now on first down. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Lawrence Taylor. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He was looking for Gronk that time. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, 2 first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? Young looks to throw on first down. Got a man right side. It's sharp. Yeah, he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing and communicating. There he is. And they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Over the middle, Sharp's got it complete. And it's a touchdown. A big play there, 76 yards, and the Madden legends have taken the early lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call, but he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, Those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Anderson now to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Madden Elite's offense trotting out again. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice enough?
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Brian Dawkins in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. On second down. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. John Randall in there to get him. And this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays.
So, Brandon, we've sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
Buying time to his left. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
Brandon, their last miss on 3rd down, they actually were able to alleviate it because they picked it up with a 4th down conversion. I don't know that they'd be wise to try and do that again here. To me, you got to punt the ball away.
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. Now Sanders. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10. It's Young off play action. He's going to wind up and air it out. Tries for Rice, intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith. And he'll get this back across the midfield, striping down to the 47-yard line. First down carry by Bell. They showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. A give to Bell. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
They go play action here on 1st down. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Bruce Smith able to get in there and drop him for a 2-yard loss.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
And that one got tipped, kind of off. It brings up 3rd.
got to give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and get some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Oh, boy, partner, did that just happen? I've got my hand over my eyes right now because, like him, it's going to haunt my dreams, too. He was wide open. How did he overthrow him there?
Defensively, just very lucky. You know that they got away with one there.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Out now come the legends. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Jerry Rice, open right side. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down.
Now, that was pretty. They executed that cone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, a sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window, he fired a bullet in there for the completion. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
A very good gain on first down, 9 yards on the dump off.
When Tony Gonzalez makes catches, sometimes I feel bad, like it's almost routine. And that's really not what the deal is. This is a guy who has to work his way open on every play because he's such a featured guy. But he's also a guy that throughout his career, there's a little bit of a loyalty and a soft spot for Kansas City, his first team. When he went to Atlanta, did you know he kept his mouthpiece from Kansas City?
And he will score. It's a touchdown. Barry Sanders, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Madden Legends will extend their lead.
A touchdown run for Barry Sanders. How about this, partner? 99 career rushing touchdowns and 10 more receiving in his NFL career.
And a stat you and I were looking over before the game, at one point he held 34 NCAA records, and in his 1988 Heisman Trophy campaign at Oklahoma State, he had 44 touchdowns in how many games?
12 games, and I'm not sure there was more excitement generated by a runner than Barry Sanders playing for Oklahoma State.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee. The Madden Elites heading back onto the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. There's Wilson, caught on the right side by Jones. No gain there on the completion, 2nd and 10. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. Play action. It's Wilson. That'll go as a loss of 5. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on 3rd and long. The offense on 3rd down tonight, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be 3rd and 15. From the gun, it's Wilson. Quickly to Gronkowski, that's caught. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Gronk's first catch, good for a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. On first and 10, it's Wilson escaping the pressure right. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. First down now, but that clock rolling. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Now Wilson. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Mean Joe Green getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of 4. Third and long, it's Wilson. And he fires one, but incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
And Tucker's kick right there, it's good. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Yeah,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. It's Rice. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
There goes Jerry Rice again, racking up catches and bunches. His 1,549 catches, a whopping 224 more than the next closest guy, the great Tony Gonzalez,
Detroit, a terrific tight end.
It's Young on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. While we have a second, Charles, the Patriots, of course, back in the Super Bowl, getting the 37-31 victory over KC in the AFC title game. Great game, but you know, the Patriots...
You know nobody believes in them.
Yeah, right. They're playing that underdog card, but I thought it was funny because after the game, they asked Tom Brady, were you guys just trying to use that for your own motivation? He said no comment because they were. They know they're not the underdog.
They know it, but when you've been that great for this long,
you need something.
You've got.
He rifles one that's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it. And the return here is stopped at the.
He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. They go play action now. Wilson. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but there must be a little bit of the Madden curse going on for our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
Flushed out right. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Back out for their next drive. Here comes Michael Vick and the Madden Legends. I'm sure he wanted to have a huge game, wants to have a huge game as the quarterback, but really on the ground, they've been very, very hard to stop. Maybe you just keep going to that well.
I think so, and isn't it funny how the definition of balance changes for us from game to game? Sometimes it's what, 50-50, run it, throw it. Sometimes it's just being a balanced running team in terms of who's carrying the football.
Not more than one guy.
Right, multiple guys out there, and now your guy back there has to throw it. Doesn't have to worry about it quite as much.
And they've got the lead here in the second quarter. Fake here on first down. Throw left side complete to Sharp. Pass the 20, 10, and this results in 6. Touchdown. A big play there in the final seconds of the first half. And his guys get the quick strike touchdown.
And that's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook. But even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff play right before the half ends.
Good point. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Anderson now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Final play of the first half, barring a penalty, as they come up on first and 10.
95.
Final play of the half. It's Wilson. He's going to air one out. It's incomplete. Took a shot. Couldn't connect. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter. Here we go. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. Fielded about a yard deep. He'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Back onto the field comes the offense for the Madden Legends. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Here's Vick off the play fake for Sanders. On the move to his left. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, the defensive guys won't be real happy because there won't be a sack on this play because he did get back to the line of scrimmage. But what a job they did overall. Hemmed him in and gave him nowhere to go with the football.
Vick goes play action. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Fletcher Cox, a able to drop him for a loss of two, and that'll bring up fourth down.
To me, the defense is looking a little gassed near the end of the first half, but they come out of the locker room with a little extra spring in their step. Wonder what they did at halftime to get them so motivated.
I don't know, but that sack looked good. Now let's see if they can build on the momentum of that play. Here goes Vic on fourth down. That'll be caught over the middle by Moss. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Facing a fourth down, they come away with 18 yards and the first down conversion. Great change up there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
Now the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside, make a move in that direction. Then you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him in the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way. Third quarter and you've got the lead, you're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Flush to his right. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. Man open, that's Terrell Owens. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft.
Trying to set up the screen, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro linebacker. It's Von Miller. 30. The 20. And put it on the board. It's 6, a touchdown. Short throw, pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that'll cut the lead to 21-17. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick 6. The Madden legends heading back onto the field and following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete for the upcoming Super Bowl. So many storylines, but one that obviously grabs you. Sean McVay just turned 33 January 24th, youngest coach ever to take a team to the Super Bowl. Double that age for Bill Belichick, who's 66, and Charles, that's the largest gap between coaches in Super Bowl history.
Yeah, and when you think about it, obviously the age comes into play, but to me it's more the experience. The number of times that the Patriots have gone to the Super Bowl with Belichick leading them versus Sean McVay's first time in the Super Bowl leading the Rams. Will that game experience come into play at all? But I do like this about Sean McVay. Raised in the game, raised up through the NFL system, no matter how young he might be. Remember, his grandfather was a head coach and a GM in the league. He gets it. He understands. I highly expect the moment to be just fine for him and not too big.
Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Hey, let's go.
They were in zone defensively, went with a crossing route. It's always interesting to watch that chess match.
Yeah, and I think safeties don't mind crossing routes against zone because eventually you're going to run into their territory, and that's when they look to
execution to find a hole, make the catch. Here's Michael Vick going up top. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Now here's Vic. That'll be caught by Rice. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
Gardner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. Anderson's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So he missed that field goal earlier, but he says not this time. Able to knock it through, give his guys three.
I like his poise. I like his confidence, his belief in himself. Sometimes when you miss that first one, you see a lot of guys sag, and they can't make the next one. Not in this case. Stepped right up like a pro.
The Madden Elite's offense coming back on the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This drive, and we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end.
And Rodgers is going to go down. He sacked. Lawrence Taylor in there to bring him down for a loss of seven. The give is to Bell. And he'll get across the 20, but only to about the 22-yard line. Give him 3 yards on the run. Now they'll need to drop something good here on third and 13.
I think when people start talking about the greatest Ravens of all time, Ray Lewis's name comes up pretty fast, doesn't it? Tackles like that, just the tip of the iceberg, and we start to talk about his talents.
He was their second pick after the move to Baltimore. What was that, 96?
Yeah, 1996. Jonathan Ogden was the first.
And Ray Lewis also two-time Super Bowl champion and the MVP of Super Bowl 35.
Hey, check 26.
They do go for it. It's Rodgers. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field.
Eagle, Eagle.
A first down throw coming for Vic. And this one is incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Vic to throw it. Forced out to his left. And he will have a touchdown. Jerry Rice. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Madden Legends will extend their lead. Now to try to add the extra point, the lefty Anderson.
We just saw one of the benefits of a quarterback having mobility. Scrambled around, kept the play alive, and then found a receiver open downfield for a touchdown.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. They go play action here on first down. Rolling to his left. Goes underneath for Bell. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. As we are set to bring you the home stretch here, the fourth quarter. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now Wilson on first down. And that is incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
This is Bell. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. The tackle by Brian Dawkins. Play action. Now Wilson. And that's complete to the right side. It's Allen. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down. Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. He sets to fire deep. And this is going to be incomplete. The fourth down pass play doesn't work out. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. Being just short of midfield, they decide to take a crack at it on fourth down. They don't come through.
Sometimes it's just showing confidence in your defense. You know that they're good, and they'll take care of you. A lot of coaches during the week will announce to their team, we're going to be a great